sent his favorite son, Joseph, to go in search of his brothers and bring them back home. So it is that God the Father sent his favorite son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to search out his brothers and sisters from West Brooklyn and to bring them home. It's called the minor sins. Times that have been hard to find. Times we have not appreciated the food placed in front of us. Times that we erroneously think in jealousy the Father loves someone else more than he loves us. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I am a great sinner. My thoughts and my words, what I've done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my misfortune. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me, Lord our God. And my God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant Almighty and merciful God, that we may in truth receive a share in the resurrection of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the letter of St. James. Blessed is he who perseveres in temptation, for when he has been proven, he will receive the crown of life that he promised Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Now I am going to the one who sent me. And not one of you asks me, 'Where are you going?' But because I told you this, grief has filled your hearts. But I tell you the truth. It is better for you that I go. For if I do not go, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. When he comes, he will convict the world in regard to sin and righteousness and condemnation. Sin, because they do not believe in me. Righteousness, because I am going to the Father, and you will no longer see me. Condemnation, because the ruler of this world has been condemned." The Gospel. To be more than a daughter of divine love. To be more than a wife. To be more than a husband. To be more than a priest. To fulfill our humanity is to be in contemplation with God. To be one with God. To be more than a man is to be a part of the body of Christ. Isn't that why you came to Mass today? To receive the Eucharist? What do we call the Eucharist? The body of Christ. You check your humanity at the front door when you enter this church. You come to this altar. You tell God, Jesus Christ, true man, true God. Jesus is more than a man. He is God. Jesus is totally in love with his Father. The Son and the Father contemplate each other. They think only of the other. So much so that Jesus wants only to do his Father's will. And what is the Father's will? Thank you. us his flesh and blood to eat and drink. That we might contemplate God, that we might make God's will our will. When the Catholic receives Holy Communion, the Eucharist, he's more than a man. She's more than a woman. We have become members of the body of Christ. We have become Christ-like by our reception of the Eucharist. We are both human and we become part divine. At peace. Call to God with all our prayers and petitions. We thank God for sending His Son Jesus Christ that we might come to our senses and return to eat a meal in the Father's house. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that Jesus Christ would convince us, the older son, we are not to be jealous of our younger brother, that we are to be thankful to God that God has saved him as well as us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray always for our beloved dead, they would experience the banquet meal in heaven. Pray especially at this Mass for Alexander and Rose McInnes. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May they rest in peace.
Amen.
The Alexander soul and Rose's soul, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Our spiritually adopted baby yearns to be loved by his parents. So we pray the Bishop St. Paul Sheen for him. Hail Mary. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, I love you very much. I beg you to spare the life of James, the unborn baby that I am spiritually adopted. In the name of your worship. Amen. We pray Hail Mary for asking Our Lady of the Assumption for the help to contemplate her son's great love for us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Heavenly Father, we ask you here to answer all of these prayers to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, but through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Thank you.
be the priest, to be the altar, and to be the lamb of sacrifice. And therefore, we're come with paths of joy, every land and every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they claim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all things. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of to yourself. Grant that they were united with your Son in a death like his, glorified.